Hello dear students, welcome to the virtual class. This is the new concept of the class. Here we will start with the class 10th science subject. This is your class 10th science book. In this total 16 chapters are there. First 5 chapters are from chemistry portion. 6 to 9 are from bio portion. 10 to 14 are from physics portion and 15 and 16 chapter again are from bio portion. So today we will start with the first chapter of the book from the chemistry portion, that is chapter 1, chemical reactions and equations. So this is the first chapter of your book, that is chemical reactions and equations. The first step is to understand the meaning of chemical reactions and equations. What does it mean? Okay, in your book at the starting, here some examples are given from your daily life. I will read these examples. Number one, milk is left at room temperature during summers. Think what will happen? And iron tawa, pan or nail is left exposed to humid atmosphere. Grapes get fermented. Food is cooked. Food gets digested in our body. We respire. So, in these examples, what do you observe? We will observe when the milk is left at room temperature during the summers, it will curdles. Iron in the humid atmosphere, when it is exposed to humid atmosphere, it will get rust. Grapes get fermented, means they will turn into alcohol. Food is cooked, that means there is the new substances formed. The properties of the raw material will change. Food gets digested in our body. The complex substances gets converted into simple substances. We respire, that is the oxidation of food to produce energy. So why these examples are given over here? Because all these examples, the new substance is formed with new properties. So that means these are the processes or these are the chemical changes. In lower classes, students, you have must learnt about the two types of the changes. One is the physical change and one is the chemical change. So, what are the physical changes? The processes in which the no new chemical substances are formed. And chemical change, the processes in which the new substance with the different properties are formed. So, the reactions or the processes in which the chemical changes are taking place that involve chemical changes are known as chemical reactions. Okay, I will repeat the definition again. The process involving a chemical change is called chemical reaction. There are two parts of the chemical reaction. One is the reactant that we write on the left hand side and the product that we will write on the right hand side. What do you mean by the reactant? Substances that undergo chemical change and the new substance that will formed after a reaction, after a change, that are called products. So our chapter is all about the chemical changes. Okay, that include the chemical reactions. Here in your book, the first activity is given. Okay, that you must have done in class 8th, in third chapter, matters and non-matters. So, what is this activity is about? The burning of a magnesium ribbon in air and collection of magnesium oxide in a watch glass. Have you seen the magnesium ribbon? Yes, we have seen in 8th class when we burned this. burn this, it will burn with a dazzling white flame. Okay, and the white colored powder we obtained, that is of magnesium oxide. Done. So, in the first activity, what is happening there? Magnesium burns in oxygen, with oxygen, and form magnesium oxide. This is white in color. Okay, and magnesium burns in air with a dazzling white flame. Remember this activity. Okay, we will do now the next activity. Now see the activity 1.2. They are saying take lead nitrate solution in a test tube, add potassium iodide solution to this, and what do you observe? Okay, I will perform these activities in the school in front of you, and we will see in the labs ki what is mainly happening over there. So what is happening in activity 1.2? Lead nitrate solution, okay, we are adding in potassium iodide solution. Then they will form lead iodide plus potassium nitrate. We will see later on why these two products will form. Now, what do you observe in this activity? That we will observe the yellow color substance formed. Okay, yellow colored substance. When we make the solution of lead nitrate, it is colorless. Potassium iodide solution's color, colorless. And it is seems to be like a magic that after mixing the two colorless solution, we will obtain yellow colored substance. Okay. Now see the activity 1.3. What they are saying? They are saying ki in a conical flask, take some zinc granules and add some dilute sulfuric acid. You must have done this activity in class 8th also. Please remember that. In a conical flask, what we have done? Zinc granules and add some dilute sulfuric acid. What do you observe? We will observe the gaseous bubbles near the zinc granules. Do you know that? Which gas is liberated? Yes, hydrogen gas. How will you identify it? When we bring a burning splinter near this gas, it will burn with popping sound. So, in activity 1.3, what is done over there? Zinc plus dilute hydrochloric acid produce zinc. It will form zinc chloride and liberate hydrogen gas. If in the place of hydrochloric acid, we will take sulfuric acid, then which salt is formed? Zinc sulfate along with hydrogen gas. So from the above three activities, we can say that any of the following observations help us to determine whether a chemical reaction has taken place. So what are the observations? One, change in state. During the reaction, there will be change in a state. Change in color, as you seen in the activity 1.2, we have dissolved, we have mixed two colorless solution and the new substance with yellow color will form. Evolution of a gas that we have seen in activity 1.3, hydrogen gas is formed. One is the change in temperature that we will do later on. So dear students, our next topic is chemical equations. What do you mean by chemical equations? The symbolic representation of a chemical change or reaction is called chemical equation. I will repeat the definition again. The symbolic representation of a chemical change or reaction is called chemical equation. There are two ways of representing any chemical reaction. Okay. The first is the word equation and second in the form of symbols or formulae. Here, all these are word equations. In the form of the words, I have written magnesium plus oxygen, magnesium oxide, lead nitrate, potassium iodide. If I will write in the place of their words, in the names of the chemicals, I will write their chemical symbols or their formulae, chemical formulae, then it will become our chemical equation in the form of symbols or chemical formulae. Before writing the chemical equations in the form of chemical symbols or formulae, we have to understand or came to know the various ionic symbols that you have must done in 9th class. Okay, you have done the positive ions and negative ions. The positive ions are called cations and the negative ions are called anions. Okay, and some polyatomic ions are also there. How do the positive ions are formed? By losing electrons. And the negative ions by gaining electrons. Okay, so here is the table of the different ions. You just look into this. Sodium, Na positive, potassium, silver, magnesium. Okay, and there are the negative ions in this. Hydrogen is there. Hydrogen having the atomic number 1, it can lose one electron or also gain one electron. So it will be in the two forms, or it may be H positive ion or H negative ion. And these are the polyatomic ion. So you have to learn these ionic symbols before doing the chemical reactions. So from that table, we are able to write the chemical symbols or their chemical formulae. For example, for this one, activity 1.1, magnesium. Okay, what is the symbol for the magnesium? That is Mg. Okay, it is a magnesium atom, not the ion. Oxygen is always existed in the form of O2, that is diatomic ion. Okay, magnesium oxide. Now, how will you write the formula for magnesium oxide? That you have done in the class 9. How we will form, write the chemical formula? That is magnesium ion. What is the chemical symbol for magnesium? Ionic symbol, that is Mg, 2 positive. For the oxide, negative ions always having the suffix, that is IDE. 2 negative is the oxide. So 2 and 2 will be cancel each other. Okay, now it will become MgO. Okay, O should be capital because it is the another element or the atom of another element. Okay, magnesium is capital M and small g. In this way, we can write the word equation in the form of symbols or chemical formulae. Okay, now this is our chemical equation. Done, students? Now, you have done in 7th class, that is the balancing of the chemical equations. Do you remember that? Hope so. Okay, what do you mean by the balancing of the chemical equation? In the balanced equation, the number of atoms of the element on the reactant side and the product side of the same element would remain same. Okay, that is the balanced chemical equation. So, first look into this reaction. Count the number of atoms of each element on both the sides. Okay. Look into the what I am doing. Look into it properly. Okay. Count the number of the atoms on the left hand side. Magnesium. Here it is 1. Okay. Because nothing is written over here. O2 means oxygen are 2. And on the right hand side, magnesium is 1 and oxygen is also 1. Is this balanced equation? No, This is not a balanced equation. This is unbalanced chemical equation in which the number of atoms of the element would not be same on the left hand side, on the reactant side and the product side, that are called unbalanced chemical equations or skeletal equation. What is the another word I am using? That is skeletal equation. Okay, now we will learn how to balance these equations. Now we have to balance this equation. So what we will do, first we will put these symbols in the box, because there is no need to change or to write any number inside the box. Okay, now the magnesium is 1 on the reactant side, oxygen is 2, and the product side magnesium is 1, oxygen is 1. So which one is need to be balanced? Here the oxygen is 2, here the oxygen is 1. Which one is need to be balanced? Oxygen. So to balance the oxygen, what will we do? Shall we write like this way? MgO2? No, this is wrong. This will change the formula of magnesium oxide. That's why I have put it in the box. Okay, so what we will do? We have to write the number in front of the chemical formula. Okay, now what will happen? Now this 2 is with magnesium and O, with both of them. So now the magnesium is 2 and our oxygen is also 2. O, what will happen? Now the here the on the reactant side magnesium is 1. Now what will we do? We will here again put the 2 in front of magnesium. Now our magnesium, here our magnesium is 2 and oxygen is also 2. Now on the both sides, the number of atoms of the element magnesium is 2, magnesium is 2, oxygen is 2, oxygen is 2. So now this reaction is a balanced reaction. So students, look into the definitions of these topics. One is the unbalanced chemical equation, the equation in which total number of atoms of each element are not same on both reactant and product side. This is also known as skeletal equation. Balanced chemical equation, it is an equation in which the total number of atoms of each element are equal on both sides of the equation. Okay. Now, the balancing of a chemical equation satisfies the which law? This question may be asked in your exams. That is the law of conservation of mass. You have learned this law in class 9. What it states? It states that mass can neither be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. Okay. So we will look into these reactions. Here the mass of the reactant side and the product side will always remain same. Okay, and this may possible due to the balancing of the chemical reaction. Now we will try to balance the next chemical equation. This example is also given in your book. That is, the reaction is Fe plus H2O gives Fe3O4 plus H2. How? The first step is to count the number of atoms of the element. Okay. So, on the reactant side, Fe is 1. Hydrogen, this 2 is with only hydrogen. Oxygen is 1. On the reactant product side, Fe is 3, hydrogen is 2 and oxygen are 4. In this reaction, always tries to balance those compounds that are having the maximum number of atoms. In this reaction, Fe3 and O4, this compound is having the maximum number of atoms. Keep in your mind, students, always balance hydrogen at the last. So first we will balance oxygen. Here the product side oxygen are 4 and here the oxygen is 1. So what will we do? We will put 4 in front of the chemical formulae of water. Okay, now the oxygen is not there in any compound. Okay, so H2O is having only the oxygen and here we will write 4. Now what will happen? R hydrogen, this would be multiplied with 2. H is 2, so it will become 8. Now hydrogen is 8 and oxygen become 4. Okay, now come to this side. Now oxygen is 4, hydrogen here 8 and here 2, iron here 1 and here 3. So now what will we do? What is our next step? Balance the iron. Okay, here it is the very simple. We will put 3 in front of iron. Okay, now our iron become 3. Hydrogen, it is 8 over here and on the production side it is 2. So we will multiply it with 4, so the product would be 8. Done. Now check it. Iron 3, hydrogen 8, hydrogen 8, oxygen 4, so now this reaction is balanced. I will give you more reactions to write their chemical equations and to balance them. That will be your homework. Okay, before that you check this topic, that is making a chemical equation more informative. Means how do you make your chemical equations more informative? Okay, the first is by writing their physical states of the reactants and products. For solid, we can write small s. For liquid, if we are taking any reactant or product in the liquid form, then we will write small l. For the gas, we will write small g, or we can put upward arrow also. Okay, along with the, for example, hydrogen is produced. So hydrogen is producing in the form of gas. So along with the hydrogen, we will put upward arrow. Aqueous, what do you mean by aqueous? The solutions in water. Okay, so we can write AQ. For example, in this reaction, the magnesium is taken in the form of solid. So we can write small s. Oxygen is in the form of gas. So we can write G. MgO, that is the white colored residue. Okay, and it is solid. So we can write solid. So in this way, our chemical equation become more informative. It will tell us about the physical states of the reactants and the products. Now the second, we can write the particular conditions or specific temperature or any requirement, any necessary substance or the catalyst, we can write in the above or below the arrow in the chemical equation. For example, here is the reaction of photosynthesis. That you all know about the photosynthesis. The carbon dioxide reacts with water. Carbon dioxide that is taken by the plant and get dissolved in the water. So that is the aqueous, and water that is liquid. So what are the necessary conditions for the reaction? What are the necessary conditions for this reaction? That is the chlorophyll and the sunlight. Okay, so we can write this above or below the arrow. That shows ki it, these are the important conditions. Okay, in the above reaction, what is the reaction? Carbon dioxide plus hydrogen. In this, the alcohol will form. ओके एंड द नेसेसरी कंडीशन इज द पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर दैट इज 340 एटमोस्फियर. डन. नाउ द वन वर्ड आई हैव यूज्ड दैट इज द कैटालिस्ट. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द कैटालिस्ट? इट इज अ सब्सटेंस दैट स्पीड्स अप द केमिकल रिएक्शन बट इटसेल्फ डू नॉट अंडरगो एनी चेंज और एनी रिएक्शन दैट आर कॉल्ड कैटालिस्ट. If the particular chemical substance is required for the reaction, then we can also write over here, okay, above or below the arrow. The one, if the evolution of heat or absorption of heat can be indicated by writing heat, or in the place of heat, we can also put triangular sign. For example, carbon plus oxygen, okay, that means it burns, okay, there is a burning of the carbon substance. So carbon dioxide gas is produced, and also when we burn wood is having carbon, okay, because all the living substances, they are having the carbon. So when they burn, they all produce heat. So we can write in the product side plus heat, or we can put triangular sign. So up to this, the introduction of the chapter is finished. Now, I hope you all must have understand all the concepts. If anyone is having any doubt, so please let me know. Now, this is your homework. There are the in-text question on the page number 6. I am also sending the PDF of this chapter. Okay, you just try. Don't try if you are knowing the answer of the first question, then you may write. Otherwise, do the question number 2 and 3 by yourself. That is your homework. In second question, 3 parts are there. And in third question, 2 parts are there. You have to read the word equations and write the chemical equations. And you have to balance it. Okay. Thank you, students. And in the next video, we will meet with a new topic. Thank you. Hello, dear students. Welcome in science class. I hope you all have understood the yesterday's concept very clearly. Okay, I have given the homework to you to solve the questions given on the page number 6 in text questions. So today we will solve these questions. So listen the answers carefully. First question is, why should a magnesium ribbon be cleaned before burning in air? We have seen in the activity 1.1, when we burn magnesium ribbon in air, it need to be cleaned. Why it should be need to cleaned? Because in air, magnesium reacts with oxygen and forms a layer of magnesium oxide that hinders the process of burning. So we will write, it needs to be cleaned with sandpaper to remove the protective layer of magnesium oxide on its surface, which hinders the process of burning of magnesium. Now read the second question. The second question is, write the balanced equation for the following chemical reactions. Here the word reactions are given and you have to write chemical in the form of chemical formulae. Okay. And you have to balance it. The first is, we have to write hydrogen. The first is hydrogen. Hydrogen always exists in the form of H2. Plus chlorine. Chlorine always exists in the form of diatomic. Only Cl2. And they react. Then they form hydrogen chloride. Hydrogen H positive, Cl negative. So when we crisscross it, it will become HCl. Now before balancing it, now check it for balancing. Yesterday we have done the various steps that are involving in balancing the chemical reaction. I will not repeat them again. So see here carefully. Here the hydrogen is 2, chlorine is 2. Here hydrogen is 1, chlorine is 1. Here is very simple. We have to write 2 and that will be with H also and Cl also. तो हियर आर हाइड्रोजन विल बी टू एंड सीएल विल बी टू. नाउ हियर द सेकेंड पार्ट इज गिवन, दैट इज बेरियम क्लोराइड. बेरियम, बेरियम इज बी ए टू पॉजिटिव, क्लोराइड सी एल नेगेटिव. देन यू क्रिस क्रॉस इट, इट विल बिकम बी ए सी एल टू. प्लस एल्यूमिनियम सल्फेट, एल्यूमिनियम ए एल थ्री पॉजिटिव, एस ओ फोर टू नेगेटिव. एंड वेन वी क्रिस क्रॉस इट, इट विल बिकम ए एल टू ब्रैकेट. इन द ब्रैकेट वी विल राइट एस ओ फोर एंड आफ्टरवर्ड वी विल पुट थ्री. इट विल बिकम ए एल टू एस ओ फोर थ्राइस. एंड देन वी विल पुट द एरो. देन बेरियम सल्फेट, बी ए टू पॉजिटिव, एस ओ फोर टू नेगेटिव. क्रिस क्रॉस इट, इट विल बिकम बी ए एस ओ फोर. अदरवाइज इट इज टू टू, तो दे विल कट इच अदर एंड इट विल बिकम बी एस ओ फोर. प्लस एल्यूमिनियम क्लोराइड, ए एल थ्री पॉजिटिव एंड सी एल नेगेटिव, तो इट विल बिकम ए एल सी एल थ्री. ओके, ए एल, एल शुड बी स्मॉल. डन. नाउ वी हैव टू बैलेंस इट. चेक हियर, बेरियम इज वन, बेरियम इज वन, सी एल, बेरियम वन, बेरियम वन, सी एल टू, सी एल थ्री, एल्यूमिनियम टू, एल्यूमिनियम वन, सल्फर. नाउ दिस थ्री इज विद सल्फर एंड ऑक्सीजन, विद बोथ ऑफ देम इट विल बी. ओके, द सल्फर इज थ्री, हियर सल्फर इज वन. ऑक्सीजन मल्टीप्लाई फोर इंटू थ्री, ट्वेल्व. ओके, एयर ऑक्सीजन इज फोर. सो बेरियम इज बैलेंस्ड, क्लोरीन नीड टू बी बैलेंस्ड, एल्यूमिनियम, सल्फर, रेस्ट ऑल नीड्स टू बी बैलेंस्ड. सो वी विल फर्स्ट, व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल बैलेंस एल्यूमिनियम. हियर एल्यूमिनियम इज टू एंड हियर एल्यूमिनियम इज वन. तो सिंपली वी विल मल्टीप्लाई हियर विद टू. नाउ एल्यूमिनियम विल टू एंड क्लोरीन, क्लोरीन इट विल बी थ्री इंटू टू, दैट विल बी सिक्स. ओके, नाउ द हेयर क्लोरीन इज टू, तो व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल मल्टीप्लाई हेयर विद थ्री. नाउ इट विल बिकम बेरियम थ्री, क्लोरीन सी एल टू सिक्स. सॉरी, मल्टीप्लाई इट विद थ्री, तो इट विल बिकम सिक्स. नाउ हेयर द बेरियम इज थ्री एंड हेयर बेरियम इज वन, तो व्हाट टू डू, वी विल मल्टीप्लाई हेयर विद थ्री. Now it will become 3. Now our sulfur also become 3. Okay. And oxygen, this will be multiplied. Okay. 4 into 3. It will become 12. Now look into it carefully. It is balanced. Barium 3, barium 3. Chlorine 6, chlorine 6. Aluminium 2, 2. Sulfur 3, 3. Oxygen 12. 12. So in this way we will balance this equation. Now read the third one. Third one is sodium, that is Na. It's a metal and it always exists in monoatomic form. Plus water. Water is H2O. It will form sodium hydroxide, Na positive, OH negative. Then crisscross it, it will become NaOH. Plus hydrogen. Hydrogen always exists in diatomic form, so it will be H2. Okay. Now for the balancing, next step is to balance it. Sodium 1, sodium 1, hydrogen 2, hydrogen. Count the number of atoms of hydrogen. 2 plus, here nothing is there, so that means 1 is there. 2 plus 1, that will be 3. Okay, oxygen 1, oxygen 1. So look here carefully, here hydrogen is 2 and hydrogen is 3. So what to do? We have to multiply here Okay, here the even odd number is there, so we have to make it even. So what to do? It's the hits and trial method. Okay, we will put 2 here. Now sodium become 2, oxygen become 2, and hydrogen 2 plus 2, it will be 4. Okay, this will be multiplied and here the plus sign is there, so they will be get added. Okay, the count the number of hydrogen atoms again. Now come to the reactant side. Here the sodium is 1 and here the sodium is 2, so we will multiply here with 2, so our sodium become 2. Okay, now hydrogen is 2, here hydrogen is 4. That is very simple, we will multiply here with 2. Now it will become 2 multiplied by 2, 4, and oxygen become 2. Okay, so in this way we have solved the question number 2 with all 3 parts. Now see the question number 3. Write a balanced chemical equation with state symbols. State, we have to write the physical states also for the following reactions. Okay, the first one is solutions of barium chloride and means plus, they are reactant. Sodium sulfate in water means they are aqueous solution. React to give insoluble. Insoluble means it is solid. Barium chloride, they are the product, and solution of sodium chloride. So now we will write the chemical formulae. Okay, solution of barium chloride. Barium, Ba2 positive, Cl negative. Crisscross it, it will become BaCl2. Now it is solution, that means in water, so we will write aqueous, Aq. Plus, because it is saying ki add, and sodium sulfate in water. Sodium sulfate, Na positive, SO42 negative. Crisscross it, it will become Na2SO4, and again aqueous because it is in water. To give means we have to write arrow. Insoluble barium sulfate. Barium, Ba2 positive, SO42 negative. They will cancel each other because both the numbers are same. Okay, so it will be BaSO4. Now it is insoluble, so we will write here solid. Plus, and it formed the solution of sodium chloride. Solution of sodium chloride, Na positive, Cl negative. So it will be NaCl. Now it's a solution, so we will write here aqueous. Okay, now we have to balance it. Count the number of barium. 1, barium 1, chlorine 2, chlorine 1, sodium 2, sodium 1, sulfur 1, sulfur 1, oxygen 4, oxygen 4. Okay, now check, barium 1, 1. Chlorine needs to be balanced. Okay, sodium needs to be balanced. Sulfur is balanced. Oxygen is balanced. So we have to check where both these atoms are present. These elements are there in a compound, NaCl. So here, if we want to balance sodium, so we have to add 2 here. Okay, now it will automatically, chlorine will become 2 and sodium will become 2. So now it is balanced. Now see the second part. Sodium hydroxide solution in water. That means it is again aqueous. Reacts with hydrochloric acid solution in water. Means again aqueous. To produce means react and produce the product. Sodium chloride solution and water. That is sodium chloride solution means it is again aqueous. Now write down the reaction. Sodium hydroxide, Na positive sodium hydroxide, OH नेगेटिव, तो इट विल बिकम एन ए ओ एच. सोल्यूशन इन वॉटर मीन्स एक्वस प्लस, रिएक्ट्स विद मीन्स प्लस, हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड एच पॉजिटिव सी एल नेगेटिव, तो इट विल बिकम एच सी एल, हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड सोल्यूशन इन वॉटर, सो वी विल एड एक्वस. नाउ रिएक्ट टू प्रोड्यूस, टू प्रोड्यूस मीन्स वी हैव टू पुट एरो. सोडियम क्लोराइड एन ए पॉजिटिव सी एल नेगेटिव, सो इट विल बिकम एन ए सी एल प्लस वॉटर मीन्स एच टू ओ, दैट इज लिक्विड एंड एन ए सी एल इज एक्वस बिकॉज सोल्यूशन इज प्रोड्यूस्ड. ओके, नाउ वी हैव टू बैलेंस इट. सोडियम वन, सोडियम वन, ऑक्सीजन वन, ऑक्सीजन वन, हाइड्रोजन वन प्लस वन, तो इट विल बी टू. हेयर हाइड्रोजन टू, क्लोरीन वन, क्लोरीन वन, चेक. सोडियम वन, ऑक्सीजन वन, हाइड्रोजन टू, क्लोरीन वन, इट इज ऑलरेडी बैलेंस्ड. ओके, तो इन दिस वे वी हैव सॉल्व द इनटेक्स्ट क्वेश्चंस. ओके, आई होप यू ऑल हैव डन these questions by yourself, so check the answers carefully, and tomorrow we will meet with the next video. Thank you, bye. Hello students, welcome in science class. Today we will start with the topic types of chemical reactions. There are five types of reactions: combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, double displacement reaction, and oxidation and reduction reactions. So we will first discuss the combination reactions. Combination reaction, the reaction in which two or more elements or compounds combine to form one single product are called combination reaction. As the name suggests, if two or more elements combine to form one single product, okay, only the one product is formed in the combination reactions. Now let's see this activity. This is the example for combination reaction. It is saying take a small amount of calcium oxide, it is generally known as quicklime, in a beaker, and slowly add water to this. Touch the beaker, okay, touch the beaker. Do you feel any change in temperature? Yes, the answer is yes. How we are knowing that? Because the bubbles are arising, and while doing the experiment, we came to know ki heat is released in this reaction, that the heat is released during this reaction. That's why the bubbles are producing and the beaker become hot. Now, what is there in the activity? That when we add calcium oxide or quicklime, this is generally known as chuna, okay, dissolved in water, it will form a solution, aqueous solution of calcium hydroxide. As in this reaction, the bubbles are producing, heat is released, so we will write heat here also. Okay, now we will write the reaction. Calcium oxide, calcium oxide, Ca2 positive, O2 negative, 2, 2 will cancel, and it will be CaO plus water, that is H2O, gives, it is in solid, that is in powder state, and liquid calcium hydroxide, Ca2 positive, OH negative. Crisscross it, it will be CaOH twice. That is aqueous solution plus heat is released. Okay, it is generally or commonly known as slaked lime. The common name of calcium hydroxide is slaked lime, and this is our quicklime. Okay, this solution of calcium hydroxide,
The solution of quicklime in water forms called calcium hydroxide is used for white washing. Earlier it was using for white washing. Now we are using POP. This is an example of combination reaction as the two reactants combine to form one single product. Okay, that's why it is called combination reaction. Now in this reaction heat is released. Okay, not in all combination reactions the heat is released, only in few cases the heat is released. So those reactions in which the heat is released along with the product, that are called exothermic reactions. Exothermic reactions in which exo means release, thermal means heat, energy. Okay, if in the reaction heat is released along with the product, then that are called exothermic reactions. Here the definition is given. Reactions in which heat is released along with the formation of products are called exothermic chemical reactions. After doing white washing, this calcium hydroxide slowly reacts with carbon dioxide present in the air. So the reaction, it is calcium hydroxide plus carbon dioxide combines to form calcium carbonate plus water. Okay, this calcium carbonate gives shiny finish to the wall. Shiny finish to the wall. This happens slowly and gradually. This is a slow process. But beta G, it is not an example of combination reaction. It is observed after doing white washing. Okay, after doing white washing, it gradually reacts with carbon dioxide and form calcium carbonate plus water. It is also the calcium carbonate is also a formula for marble. Calcium carbonate, it is also the formula for marble. Okay, so this is the example of quicklime dissolved in water and it will form slaked lime that is used for white washing. Now we will discuss some more examples of combination reactions, as one is the burning of carbon or coal. Carbon is there in wood, coal, coke, charcoal. Okay, when it burns means it reacts with oxygen. It reacts with oxygen and it will gives carbon dioxide. So this is the combination reaction. Two reactants combine to form one single product. So it is a combination reaction. Otherwise, all the burning reaction or the combustion reactions, they are producing heat. That's why they are also known as exothermic reactions. Okay, one more example is of burning of magnesium ribbon. Okay, that will also produce magnesium oxide. Single product is formed, heat is released. That's why it is also a combination as well as exothermic reaction. One more example of combination reaction, that is the formation of water. H2 plus O2 gives H2O. Okay, always remember to balance the chemical reactions. Okay, always your reactions should be balanced. So this is the combination reaction, but it is not an exothermic reaction because in this reaction the heat is not released. Okay, H2 plus O2, these are in the gaseous form. When they react, they form the water, that is our H2O. It is an example of combination reaction, but not an example of exothermic reaction. So in the exam, if the examples of combination reactions may be asked, so you can write any example of combination reaction. If they asked for exothermic reaction, you can write this one, you can write this, you can write of magnesium burning ribbon also. Okay, Now we will do some other examples of mainly exothermic reactions, but that are not combination but only the exothermic. The first one is burning of natural gas. These examples are given in your book also. Burning of natural gas. Natural gas is CH4. It is commonly known as biogas. Okay. In the biogas reactors, it is formed. That is CH4. When it burns in the presence of oxygen, it burns. It will form carbon dioxide gas plus H2O in the form of vapors. Okay. Now let's see. Here two products are formed, so it is not a combination reaction, but in this reaction heat is released, so it is an exothermic reaction. Okay, now there is need to balance it. Carbon 1, hydrogen 4, hydrogen 2. So here we will multiply it with 2. Now the hydrogen become 4, but our oxygen 2 plus 2, 4. Now, so here we will write 2. So it is balanced. The second example is respiration. Respiration, that is the oxidation of glucose to produce energy. We need energy to stay alive. Okay, and we get this energy from food. Whatever we eat, we get energy from that. For example, if we write eat rice, potato, bread, okay, anything you can eat, then it get digested in our body. Digested means breaks down into simpler substances, simpler soluble substances. It get converted to that simpler substances, glucose. After that, this glucose get react with oxygen. This is respiration. Okay, the oxidation of glucose to produce energy is called respiration. As in this process, energy is produced, energy is released. So it is an example of exothermic reaction. So the reaction is C6H12O6, that is the glucose get oxidized, means reacts with oxygen, then it form carbon dioxide plus water and energy. So that's why the respiration is considered as an exothermic reaction. In the exam, this question may be asked ki how do you think that the respiration is an exothermic reaction or process. So in this way, you can explain this reaction and you can also write this reaction also. In this reaction, two or more products are formed. That's why this is not a combination reaction, but the energy is released. That's why it is an example of exothermic reaction. Okay. Now the third example that is given in our book of exothermic reaction is decomposition of vegetable matter. That is the composting. Composting. In this process, energy is released. That's why this is also considered as exothermic reaction. That is only the example of decomposition of vegetable matter. Okay. So in this way, what we have done, combination reactions, two or more reactants combined to form one single product. Example of quicklime, dissolved in water forms slaked lime, that is used for whitewashing. Heat is also released, so this is considered as exothermic reaction. Gradually this slaked lime combines with carbon dioxide present in air and gives a shiny finish to the wall. And this calcium carbonate is also a formula for marble. Some other examples of combination reactions, that is the burning of coke, burning of magnesium ribbon, formation of water. And some other examples of exothermic reactions, that is the burning of natural gas. One is the respiration, that is the oxidation of glucose to produce energy. And last one is decomposition of vegetable matter. So this is all about the combination reaction. I hope you all are able to understand it properly. Thank you. Students, welcome in science class. In previous session, we have done combination reaction. So today we will do the next type of the reaction, that is the decomposition reaction. Decompose, breaking down. A reaction in which a single reactant breaks down to form two or more products is called decomposition reaction, in which the one single reactant breaks down into two or more products. This is the opposite of combination reaction. In combination reaction, two or more compounds combine together to form the single product. Here, the single reactant breaks down to form two or more products. Okay, now to decompose anything or to break anything, we have to supply energy. We have to give energy. Okay, so in the decomposition reactions, we have to give energy in the form of, maybe it is in the form of heat, electricity, or in the form of light. So in this reaction, we are giving energy. That's why they are called endothermic reactions. Endothermic reactions. Endo means absorb or gain energy, or absorb energy. That's why the decomposition reactions are called endothermic reactions. Reactions in which heat is absorbed are called endothermic reactions. So on the basis of form of energy required for the reaction, displacement reactions are of three types. If they are using heat, okay, they are using energy in the form of heat, then it is called thermal decomposition. Thermal refers to heat. If it is using energy in the form of electricity, then it is called electrolysis or electrolytic decomposition. If they are using energy in the form of light, then it is called photolysis or photochemical decomposition or photo decomposition. Okay, so one by one we will discuss all the types of the decomposition reactions. The first is thermal decomposition reaction, in which we are giving energy in the form of heat, that are called thermal decomposition reaction. See this activity that is given in your book. Take about 2 gram of ferrous sulfate crystals in a dry boiling test tube. It is a test tube. Note the color of the ferrous sulfate crystals. It is of green color, light green color. Heat the boiling tube over the flame. In this manner, we are heating it. Okay. Observe the color of the crystals after heating. What happens? Yeah, what are the observations of this reaction that we will discuss? It is saying to heat the ferrous sulfate crystals. Ferrous refers to Fe2 positive and sulfate SO4 2 negative. The formula is FeSO4. And it is of light green color, okay, green colored crystals. Crystals means they are having a shape, okay. Now, this green color is due to the presence of 7 water molecule in it. The one formula of FeSO4 contains 7 water molecules. Due to these 7 water molecules, it is of green color. Now we will heat it. FeSO4.7H2O. We are heating it. So we will write triangular sign, or we will write heat over here, to show that we are giving energy in the form of heat. So first of all, it will become FeSO4 by losing 7 water molecule. Now from the green colored, it will become white color. It will of white color. From this, we came to know the green color is due to the presence of these water molecules. Further, when we heat it, FeSO4, on further heating, it will form reddish brown color residue of ferric oxide. Ferric, Fe3 positive, oxide O2 negative, Fe2O3, that is the solid residue, plus there is the smell of burning sulfur, that are the observations of this reaction of heating FeSO4 crystals. Okay, and the smell of burning sulfur is of sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. They both are gases, so we will write here G. Okay, so this is the reaction of heating green colored crystals of FeSO4. After heating, they will produce reddish brown color residue of ferric oxide, and the indication of smell of burning sulfur, that is SO2 and SO3, indicates that we are heating any sulfate salt. Okay, on the heating of any sulfate salt, SO2 and SO3 is produced, and the smell of burning sulfur will produce. These are the observation in the exam. The question may be asked, if we are heating any X salt, burning sulfur of a smell is smell of burning sulfur is there, then identify the X and the gases that are producing smell of burning sulfur. Okay, so these type of questions may be asked in the exams. Now we will balance this. Here the Fe is 2, so we will put 2 here, okay, Fe2 sulfur 2, 1 plus 2, sulfur 2, oxygen 4, 2's are 8, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 3, 8, so it is balanced. Done, this is our first example of thermal decomposition reaction. Now the second example of thermal decomposition reaction is the heating of calcium carbonate, CaCO3. Okay, when we heat it, CaCO3, when we heat it, we will write heat here. Okay, it will form calcium oxide, that is a quick lime. Calcium carbonate, it is of white color powder, and quicklime, that is also of white color powder. Okay, plus it will release CO2 gas. CO2 gas can be identified when it pass through lime water, it turns milky. That we will discuss later on. Okay, now these are the indications of this reaction, that here the quicklime is formed and the carbon dioxide gas is produced. This quicklime, this calcium oxide, it is of many uses, and mainly it is used in the manufacturing of cement. Students, this is given in your book. Okay, so this is our second example. Here the one reactant breaks down into two or more products. Okay, now our third reaction. This is the third example for thermal decomposition reaction, that take about 2 gram of lead nitrate powder in a boiling tube. Hold the boiling tube with pair of tongs and heat it over a flame. What do you observe? Note down the change, if any. lead nitrate. It is of white color powder. Lead nitrate. Lead Pb2 positive, nitrate NO3 negative. Crisscross it PbNO3 twice. Okay, this is powder, white powder. Okay, when we heat it, the main observation is brown fumes are produced. Brown fumes are produced and yellow residue is left behind. That is the main observation of this reaction. Yellow residue, that is of lead oxide. Lead oxide, Pb2 positive, O2 negative, 2 will be cancelled. PbO plus brown fumes, that is of nitrogen dioxide, that is NO2, it's a gas because the fumes are producing, plus oxygen. So this is the reaction. Lead nitrate, white color powder, on heating produce yellow residue, that is lead oxide, plus brown fumes of nitrogen dioxide, and plus oxygen gas is released. That is the main example of thermal decomposition reaction. Okay, so we have done the three examples of thermal decomposition reaction. One is the heating of ferrous sulfate crystals that are of green color. The residue is left behind, that is ferric oxide, reddish brown in color, and smell of burning sulfur is produced, that is of SO2 and SO3. Then heating of calcium carbonate, that they form quicklime and carbon dioxide, and quicklime is used in the manufacturing of cement. Now the third example we have done, that is the heating of lead nitrate, okay, yellow residue of lead oxide and brown fumes of nitrogen dioxide plus oxygen are formed. So in this reaction, one single reactant decompose and form two or more products. That's why they are called decomposition, but we are using heat to decompose them, that's why they are thermal decomposition reaction. Okay. Second type of decomposition reaction is electrolytic decomposition. Means in these, the compounds are decomposing by supplying electricity. Okay. In our book, this activity is given, activity 1.7, take a plastic mug, drill two holes at the base and fit rubber stoppers in these holes and insert graphite rods. These black colored rods are graphite rods and they are electrodes. These are called electrodes. Connect these electrodes to a 6 volt battery. Attach these electrodes with battery. Battery is having two terminals, one is positive and other one is negative. Positive and negative. The electrode that is connected to the positive side of the battery, that is called anode. Okay. The electrode attached to positive terminal of the battery is called anode. And that electrode connected to negative terminal of the battery is called cathode. Then fill the mug with water such that the electrodes are immersed, means dip in the water. Add a few drops of dilute sulfuric acid to the water to make the water more conductive. Take two test tubes filled with water and invert them over the two carbon electrodes. Take two test tubes and invert them on the electrodes so that if the gases are produced, that may be collected in these test tubes. Switch on the current and leave the apparatus undisturbed for some time. Now the observation. What do we observe? You will observe the formation of bubbles. Here the bubbles are produced, okay, at both the electrodes. These bubbles displace water in the test tubes and get collected at the top of the test tubes. Is the volume of the gas collected the same in both the test tubes? See here carefully. Okay, these empty spaces indicates the presence of the gas. Here the space is more than that of this. In this test tube, the space occupied by the gas is less, and here the more. The more space is occupied by hydrogen. That means the hydrogen amount is more than that produced, more than that of oxygen. So is the volume of the gases collected? That is no. Once the test tubes are filled with the respective gases, remove them carefully and test these gases one by one, bringing a burning candle close to the mouth of the test tube. All we know that when we bring the burning candle near the hydrogen gas, it burns with popping sound. And when we bring the burning candle near the oxygen gas, the flame burn fast or brightly. What happens in each case that we have discussed? Which gas is present in each test tube? Okay, that we will see. What actually happens during the electrolysis of water? The high water get dissociated into H positive and O2 negative ions. Okay, and these ions moves to opposite electrodes at cathode, that is negative electrode attached to negative terminal of the battery. Here the H positive ion will come, okay, and at anode, that is positive electrode, O2 negative ions will come. The opposite ions moves to opposite electrodes. Okay, now the H positive ion, it is positive, so that means it is deficient in one electron. So it will gain one electron and become hydrogen atom. First it become atom, but hydrogen do not exist alone in monatomic form, so it combines with another hydrogen atom and form H2, that is hydrogen gas. Okay, now to on balancing, here H is 2, here it is 2, and electrons also 2. Now it is balanced. So in this way the hydrogen gas formed at cathode. Okay, now what happens at anode? O2 negative ions reach anode. They are negative, that means they are having two more electrons. So they will lose these electrons and O2 negative become O atom plus 2 electrons it will lose. Now O oxygen, it also do not exist in monoatomic form or alone, it will not be able to exist. So it will combines with another O and forms O2. Okay, now on balancing, here it will become 2, the electrons, 2 2s are 4, so here 4 electrons will come. Now in this way hydrogen and oxygen gases get collected at anode and cathode. At cathode hydrogen gas and at anode oxygen gas get collected. Okay, there is no need to learn these reactions for the first chapter. Okay, this we are doing only for more clarity. How to write the balanced equation? H2O on passing electricity form H2 and O2, these are in the gaseous form. On balancing, for balancing here H2, H2, O1, O2. So here we will put 2. Now the hydrogen 2 2s are 4. Here we will put 2. From this balanced equation, we came to know the volume or amount of hydrogen produced is double than that of oxygen. Okay, and in the water also, water molecule, hydrogen and oxygen ratio is 2:1. So this is the electrolysis of water and electrolytic decomposition. We will do third type of decomposition reaction, that is photolytic decomposition, in which we are supplying energy in the form of light. See this activity. Take about 2 gram silver chloride in a china dish. What is its color? It is of white color. Place this china dish in sunlight for some time. Okay, and observe the color of the silver chloride after some time. It will turn gray. From white color, it will turn gray due to the presence of light. On coming in contact with light, it get decomposed. Silver chloride, Ag positive, Cl negative, it will become AgCl solid because it is a powder, white color powder. It turns gray in the presence of sunlight due to the formation of silver, and Ag and Cl both get decomposed. Breakdown will happen and it will Cl, it will release in the form of gas Cl2, because Cl do not exist in monoatomic form. It's a gas, it's a solid. From white color it changes to gray. Okay, so we always stored silver chloride in dark colored bottles. This question may be asked in exam, so you will write this reaction or in word form you can explain. The another example is of silver bromide, AgBr. It is of pale yellow color salt. On coming in contact with light, it also turns gray due to the formation of Ag plus Br released in the form of gas. Now we have to balance the equations also. Ag1, Cl here 2. So we will put here 2, here 2. And for balancing this, we will also put here 2. Okay. So these are the examples of photolytic decomposition. And these two reactions were used in black and white photography. Okay. So we have done the three types of decomposition reaction: thermal decomposition, electrolytic decomposition, and photolytic decomposition or photochemical decomposition. Okay, thank you. Hello dear students, welcome in science class. In today's session, we will discuss third type of the reaction, that is displacement reaction. The reaction in which more reactive metal displaces lesser reactive metal from its salt solution, that is called displacement reaction, in which more reactive metal displaces lesser reactive metal from its salt solution, that is called displacement reaction. Before doing the examples of this reaction, we need to learn the reactivity series that helps in doing this displacement type of reactions. Reactivity series is the series of arrangement of metals in decreasing order of their reactivities. You have done this reactivity series in 8th standard also. There is one method to learn it, that is a very simple way to learn this reactivity series. You can speak along with me. Kedar Nath Ka Mali Alu Zara Fike Pakata Hai. K for potassium, Na for sodium, Ca for calcium, M magnesium, Al aluminium, Zn zinc, Fe iron, P for Pb lead, H for hydrogen. Okay, केदारनाथ का माली आलू जरा फीके पकाता है. पोटाशियम, सोडियम, कैल्शियम, मैग्नीशियम, एल्यूमिनियम, जिंक, आयरन, लेड, हाइड्रोजन. इन द लास्ट फोर मेटल्स आर लेफ्ट दैट यू कैन लर्न इन द वे कॉल मी समथिंग गुड. C copper, M mercury, S silver, G gold. Copper, mercury, silver, gold. And the formula are copper Cu, mercury Hg, silver Ag, gold Au. In this way, you can learn the reactivity series. Now, in this reactivity series, the metal that is placed at the top of the reactivity series that is most reactive, okay, and at the last, the metal that is present, it is least reactive. And the metals are arranged in decreasing order. As we move downward in the reactivity series, the reactivity of the metals goes on decreasing. Okay, if you want to check the reactivity of magnesium and aluminium, between these two metals, which one is more reactive? Magnesium placed first, so it is more reactive than that of aluminium. Okay, with the help of this reactivity series, now we are able to do the displacement reaction. See this activity. Take three iron nails and clean them by rubbing with sandpaper to remove the layer of the oxide. Take two test tubes marked A and B. In each test tube, take about 10 ml copper sulfate solution. Copper sulfate solution, it is of blue color. Tie two iron nails with a thread and immerse them carefully in the copper sulfate solution in test tube B for about 20 minutes. Keep one iron nail aside for comparison. Keep one iron nail for the comparison. After 20 minutes, take out the iron nails from the copper sulfate solution. Compare the intensity of the blue color of copper sulfate solution in test tubes and also compare the color of iron nails. After 20 minutes, you will observe brown color coating on iron nail, okay, that you can compare with the original one, and the color of copper sulfate solution in test tube B will fade. Okay, it turns to light green. This is the intensity of the blue color of the copper sulfate. It is dark and it is light. So what happens in this reaction? Iron, that is in the solid form, plus copper sulfate, copper sulfate solution. Copper Cu2 positive, sulfate SO4 2 negative. 2 will cancel. Okay, it will be CuSO4. It is the aqueous solution. That means the solution is prepared in water and it is of blue color. So now see from the reactivity series. Iron is placed here and copper is here. Okay. Iron is more reactive than that of copper. Iron being more reactive than that of copper displaces it. Iron will displace copper. Okay. So what will form? it will form ferrous sulfate. Fe2 positive, SO4 2 negative, 2 2 cancel, and it will be FeSO4 plus copper get displaced. So Cu. In this way, the blue color of the copper sulfate fades and it become light green, as the crystals of ferrous sulfate color is light green. So solution also become light green. And on iron nail, we will observe the coating of copper, that is brown coating on iron. Okay. Now this is the displacement reaction. What are the observations of this reaction? One, the brown coating of copper formed on iron nail and the blue color of dark blue color of copper sulfate will fade. This is the observation. Okay. This reaction is already balanced. Now we will do the second example, that is what happens when we put zinc metal in copper sulfate solution. It is aqueous. Okay, again its color is blue. What will happen? Check from the reactivity series, reactivity of zinc and copper. Zinc placed first, so zinc is more reactive than that of copper, so it will displace copper and form zinc sulfate. Zinc sulfate, Zn2 positive, SO4 2 negative, 2 2 cancel, and it will be ZnSO4. This is aqueous solution. Here we will write also aqueous and solid, and copper get displaced. Okay, now the blue color will fade as the zinc sulfate is colorless, and brown coating is observed on zinc metal. Okay, it is of like silver color or white in color, you can say. Okay, so brown coating is formed on zinc. This is also the example of displacement reaction. One more example we will do. For example, lead. If we will put lead in copper chloride, CuCl2, Cu2 positive, Cl1 negative, crisscross, it will be CuCl2. It is blue-green solution, blue-green colored solution. Okay, now see the reactivity of lead and copper. Lead, again the lead is more reactive than that of copper, so it will displace it and it will form lead chloride. Lead chloride, Pb2 positive, Cl negative, PbCl2. This is aqueous solution plus copper. Okay, the color of lead chloride is colorless solution. So you can write the blue-green observations. You can write blue-green color fades. Gradually it fades away. And the brown coating of copper is formed on lead. One more example we will do. If we will put in copper sulfate solution, we will put silver. Then what happens? Copper sulfate solution. In copper sulfate solution, we will keep silver. Silver, see in the reactivity series, silver, it is placed below the copper. So silver is less reactive than that of copper. Okay, so it do not displace it and no reaction will take place. On the basis of these reactions, the question may be asked in the exam, in the reasoning form questions may be asked. You can simply write, if the observations are there, if the displacement takes place, so you can write, being the metal more reactive, so it displaces the metal, and that is the reason of observed statement. Okay, So this is all about the displacement reaction. Thank you. Hello dear students, welcome in science class. In today's session we will do the next type of the reaction, that is double displacement reaction. In the previous session that we have done, that is the single displacement, and this is double displacement. The reaction in which there is an exchange of ions between the reactants or two salt solutions, that are called double displacement reaction. Okay, there will be the exchange of ions between the two reactants or salt solutions, that are called double displacement. For example, if there are two salt solutions, we are talking for salt solutions. We will take the salts in the form of solutions, means aqueous plus CD, aqueous. In general, we can write, if A is positive, B is negative, C is positive, D is negative, there will the exchange of ions takes place, means A positive and D negative combines to form AD and they will combine to form CB. Okay, so these two salts will form. This is double displacement. In some of the double displacement reaction, otherwise two salt solutions are formed. But among these two salt solution, one insoluble salt will form. Insoluble salt will form, or that is solid in state, that are called precipitate. That salt that is insoluble in water, that get precipitated out or separate out as a solid, that is called precipitate. Such insoluble substance is called precipitate. And such type of reactions in which the precipitate are formed, that are called precipitation reactions. Precipitation reaction. The other one will be soluble and it is the aqueous solution. Okay, double displacement reaction, there will be the exchange of ions takes place between the two salt solutions. In the product, the two salts are formed, but if one salt is solid form, in solid form or insoluble salt, that is called precipitate, and such type of double displacement reactions are called precipitation reactions. See this activity. Take about 3 ml of sodium sulfate solution in a test tube, sodium sulfate solution in a test tube, and in another test tube take 3 ml of barium chloride, 3 ml of barium chloride. Mix the two solution and what do you observe? We will observe the white colored precipitate in this reaction. Insoluble, here the white colored insoluble substance will formed, that is called precipitate. Okay, let's see the reaction. Sodium sulfate solution, sodium Na positive, SO4 2 negative, crisscross Na2SO4, aqueous solution plus barium chloride. Okay, barium Ba2 positive, chloride Cl negative, crisscross BaCl2 aqueous solution. Okay, the color of these aqueous solutions is colorless. These two solutions are colorless. When we mix these two colorless solutions, it will form two new products, okay, by exchanging their ions. So Na positive and Cl negative combines to form NaCl, that is our common salt, and get dissolved in water. Okay, so it will not get precipitated out. And Ba2 positive, SO4 2 negative, 2 2 cancel, so it will be BaSO4. This is the solid substance. This is the precipitate, precipitated out. Okay, here the color is white. the barium sulfate is of white color, then you will observe the white colored PPT. In short form, it is also written as PPT, and also we can put downward arrow that indicates the precipitate formed. Okay, so BaSO4 barium sulfate is formed in the white color. PPTs are formed of barium sulfate, NaCl, that is the sodium chloride, it's the aqueous solution. So in this reaction, exchange of ions takes place and the precipitate also formed. So this is called precipitation reaction. Now we need to balance it. Sodium 2, sodium 1. So we will write 2 here. Sulfur 1, sulfur 1. Oxygen 4, oxygen 4. Barium 1, barium 1. Cl2, Cl2. So it is balanced. Students, recall this activity that we have done in the beginning. Okay, take lead nitrate solution in a test tube. Two salt solutions we have to take. One is the lead nitrate and other one is potassium iodide. This is also the example of double displacement reaction. And here we have written the observation that yellow colored substance is formed. So let's see what happens. Lead nitrate, Pb2 positive, NO3 negative, it will be PbNO3 twice, plus potassium iodide, K positive, I negative, so it will Ki, aqueous solution, this is also aqueous. They both are colorless solutions in water. They are colorless. Now the exchange of ions takes place. Pb2 positive, I negative. PbI2 plus K positive, NO3 negative, KNO3. That is potassium nitrate. And this is lead iodide. Now this is get dissolved in water, so its aqueous solution will form, and this is insoluble. You will get very beautiful yellow colored PPT of lead iodide. Okay, it do not get dissolved in water, so it get precipitated out and the color is yellow. Lead nitrate dissolved in potassium iodide solution, then the yellow colored PPT of lead iodide will form. So these two are the double displacement reaction, two are the examples of double displacement reaction and precipitation reaction. One more example we can write, that is of silver nitrate. Silver nitrate, Ag positive, NO3 negative. Students, here we have to balance it also. Pb1 N, this is in bracket, so 2 N is 2, so we will put here 2. Now our oxygen, 3 2s are 6, potassium is 2, potassium is 2, iodine is 2, iodine is 2, so it is balanced. Silver nitrate solution, that is AgNO3, aqueous solution, it is colorless solution, plus sodium bromide. Sodium bromide, Na positive, Br negative, NaBr. Aqueous solution, this is also colorless. Exchange of ions, okay. Ag positive, Br negative, that is AgBr plus Na positive, NO3 negative, NaNO3. It get dissolved in water, okay. So its aqueous solution we will obtain. And here the yellow PPT, pale yellow colored PPT of silver bromide we will obtain. okay, it will get precipitated out. So these are the examples of double displacement reaction. Here the exchange of ions takes place. Thank you. Hello dear students, welcome in science class. In today's session we will do the last fifth type of reaction, that is oxidation and reduction reaction. Oxidation, the process which involves gain of oxygen, and reduction which involves loss of oxygen or removal of oxygen. These both are opposite. Or in terms of hydrogen, oxidation is loss or removal of hydrogen, and reduction is gain of hydrogen. In terms of electrons, we can also write the definition of both of them. Oxidation, loss of electrons, and reduction, gain of electrons. So in terms of oxygen, hydrogen and electrons, we can learn the definitions of oxidation and reduction or understand the concept. Oxidation means get oxidized, gaining of oxygen. If element gain oxygen, then it is oxidation. If loss oxygen, reduction. Loss of hydrogen, opposite, oxidation, and gain of hydrogen, reduction. These oxidation and hydrogen gaining and losing, that is opposite in both two cases. In oxidation, gain of oxygen, loss of hydrogen, and in reduction, loss of oxygen, gain of hydrogen. And in terms of electrons, loss of electrons, that is oxidation, O here, O here. Okay, in this way you can remember this. Oxidation, loss of electrons, and reduction, gain of electrons. Okay, but think for a while. If one substance wants to gain oxygen, it means some other substance should be there that will lose oxygen. Okay, that means these two both reaction do not take place independently. Okay, they both take place simultaneously or together. That's why these reactions are called redox reactions. Okay, these reactions are called redox reaction. RE for reduction, RED for reduction, and OX for oxidation. Okay, those reactions in which oxidation and reduction reactions takes place simultaneously are called redox reactions. Okay, now we will do the example. See this activity. Heat a china dish containing about 1 gram of copper powder. Copper, it is of brown color. What do you observe? We will observe after heating, on heating, the black colored coating is there on this copper powder. That means it reacts with oxygen and it will form copper oxide black colored coating. So the reaction is copper, that is in powder, so it's solid. Oxygen on heating, so we will write here heat. Okay, it will form black colored coating on it, that is of copper oxide. Copper Cu2 positive, oxide 2 negative, 2 cancel, and it will be CuO. Okay, the black colored coating or black colored substance will form, that is called copper oxide. Here the copper gains oxygen. Okay, so oxidation takes place. Now to balance it, Cu1, oxygen 2, O1. So we will put here 2 and copper also become 2. So here we will write 2. Now on further, they are saying when we pass hydrogen gas over this on black colored compound, we will pass hydrogen gas. On passing hydrogen gas, again the brown color coating will get back. The brown color substance we will get back and water will form. Now what happens? CuO will lose oxygen. There will be the loss of oxygen and it will become Cu. And H2 will gain oxygen and form H2O. Okay. So here the oxidation and reduction takes place. How? See again. CuO, loss oxygen and get reduced, or here the reduction takes place of copper oxide. H2, here the removal of oxygen, and H2 gains this oxygen, and H2 gains and become H2. So here it is oxidation. Now this is the example of redox reaction. One substance get reduced and other get oxidized. Here we need to learn some definitions. Okay. Now from this equation we are able to learn few definitions. One is oxidized, means the substance that gain oxygen is said to be oxidized. Okay, if a substance gain oxygen is said to be oxidized. Okay, in this reaction H2 gains oxygen, so H2 get oxidized. The second one is reduced. The substance removes oxygen is said to be reduced. If the substance removes oxygen, they are said to be reduced. In this reaction, CuO will remove oxygen, okay, and get converted into Cu. Here the removal of oxygen takes place. So CuO, that is copper oxide, is said to be reduced. Done. The second one is, next one, oxidizing agent. Okay. Agents are those people that help others. Okay, so here are the substances that helps other in oxidation and reduction, but itself they get oxidized or reduced. See the definition. Oxidizing agent means the substance which helps in oxidation of others. It helps the other substance to be get oxidized. Means itself it get reduced. It will lose oxygen. Okay. Substance that undergoes reduction but helps in oxidation of other substance. The substance that undergoes reduction but helps in the oxidation of other substance. In this reaction, which compound helps in oxidation of others? Copper oxide. It is removing oxygen. That's why the H2 gains oxygen. That means CuO is a oxidizing agent. Understood? CuO, copper oxide, is oxidizing agent because itself get reduced. It removes oxygen, that's why H2 gains oxygen. Now the reducing agent. The substance undergoes oxidation but helps in reduction of other substance. Okay, that itself undergo oxidation but helps in the reduction. That's why it is called reducing agent. So in this reaction H2, it gets oxidized. Okay, because it is taking oxygen from copper oxide. So it helps in reduction of copper oxide. So here H2 is the reducing agent. These substances oxidizing agent, reducing agent, these may be asked in exams. Okay, the reaction is given and you have to write the substance that get oxidized, reduced, oxidizing agent and reducing agent. Now we will do few examples. Say this example, zinc oxide plus carbon gives Zn plus Co. See here carefully, zinc oxide, it is having oxygen, that means it will remove oxygen. When it removes oxygen, then it becomes Zn. That is the reduction. Okay. Carbon, it will lose oxygen and it will gain. So it will gain oxygen and become CO. So it is oxidation. Now, the substance that get oxidized, which one get oxidized? That is carbon. Reduced, whose undergo reduction? That is ZnO. Now which one is oxidizing agent? That get reduced, itself get reduced and helps in the oxidation of other, that is ZnO. Reducing agent is carbon. Beta, listen one thing, oxidizing agent and reducing agent, they both are opposite to oxidized and reduced, because the substance that get reduced is the oxidizing agent and the substance that get oxidized is the reducing agent. And always remember that while writing these compounds or these answers, examples, always write the compounds that are given on the product side. Sorry, on the reactant side. Okay, C, ZNO, ZNO, C, that is from the reactant side. The second example is this one. MnO2, it will remove oxygen, then it will become, means reduction will be there, MnO2, so it will undergo reduction, removes oxygen. What about HCl? HCl do not gain oxygen but it will remove hydrogen. Removal of hydrogen is also oxidation. Okay, so it will get oxidized into Cl2, that is the oxidation. Now write down the substances. Oxidized, which one is oxidized? That undergoes oxidation, that is HCl. Which one get reduced? That undergoes reduction, that is MnO2. Which one is oxidized? That undergo reduction, MnO2, because they both are opposite. Reducing agent, the substance that get oxidized. So in this manner you can also find out the substance oxidized reduced in other reactions also, and you can also give the answers in the exam. Okay, these questions may be asked in the exams also, beta ji. So do it carefully.